Привет, геймеры и читеры.
Hello, gamers and cheaters.
Много лет назад я изготовил.
Many years ago, I built for my friend this mouse click emulator on a CMOS chip. And I was recently contacted by a gamer whose autoclicker didn't work on his first try. While discussing this project, an idea came to me to build an emulator circuit on just one transistor. This scheme works very simply. The control signal from the audio output of a smartphone, player, or computer goes to an integrating circuit consisting of a diode and a capacitor. The integrated signal goes to the base of the transistor. The transistor opens and closes the left mouse button circuit. The purpose of the other circuit elements is as follows. R1 limits the input signal current. R2 prevents the base circuit of VT1 from breaking. R3 limits the base current of VT1 and increases the time constant of C1R2. In this circuit, I used germanium semiconductors, each with 0.2 volts dropping on them. This allowed the use of a low-level signal source. For example, the amplitude of my smartphone's output signal is only 1.2 volts. To measure the amplitude value of the signal, you need to open an audio file in the player with a recording of a sinusoidal signal at a frequency of, for example, 1 kHz and measure it with a multimeter. The measurement result must be multiplied by the root of 2. And if the signal amplitude exceeds 2 volts, you can safely use any low-power silicon diode and the same transistor. There will be 0.6 volts drop on each of them. Various radio components you can order on this site and still get a big bonus. The site has a convenient search engine that will make it easy to find even rare radio parts. Links to the site and to other materials in this video are in the video description. I assembled the autoclicker circuit using the point-to-point method and placed it in the body of a disposable syringe. I didn't add a switch to the circuit because I can use the start, stop button of the player itself instead. This mouse already has a slot connected to the left button. I will use it to demonstrate how the autoclicker works. As a signal source, you can use one of the ready-made audio files with recording of frequency parcels. In the player, you need to loop the playback to do this. That's how it works. Or you can create similar a file yourself by specifying the necessary sequence of clicks in the free Audacity audio editor. But finally, you can use your favorite music track or even an entire playlist as a source. You can change the click frequency by adjusting the player's volume level. Good luck. Hope you will win. See you on the channel.